Now that we are familiar with Euler's method, let's do an exercise that tests our mathematical understanding of it, or at least the process of using it. So it says, consider the differential equation. The derivative of y with respect to x is equal to 3x minus 2y. Let y is equal to g of x be a solution to the differential equation with the initial condition g of 0 is equal to k, where k is constant. Euler's method, starting at x equals 0 with a step size of 1, gives the approximation that g of 2 is approximately 4.5. Find the value of k. So once again, this is saying, hey, look, we're going to start with this initial condition. When x is equal to 0, y is equal to k. We're going to use Euler's method with a step size of 1. So we're essentially going to use, we're going to step once from 0 to 1, and then again from 1 to 2. And then that approximation is going to give us 4.5. And so given that we started at k, we should be able to figure out what k was to get us to g of 2 being approximated as 4.5. So with that, I encourage you to pause the video and try to figure this out on your own. I am assuming you have tried to figure this out on your own. Now we can do it together. And I'll do the same thing that we did in the first video on Euler's method. I'll make a little table here. So let me make a little table. I could draw a straighter line than that. That's only marginally straighter, but it'll get the job done. So let's make this column x. I'm gonna give myself some space for y. I might do some calculation here. Y and then dy, dy, dx. Now, we can start at our initial condition. When x is equal to 0, y is equal to k. When x is equal to 0, y is equal to k. And so what's our derivative gonna be at that point? Well, dy dx is equal to 3x minus 2y. So in this case, it's 3 times 0 minus 2 times k, which is just equal to negative 2k. And so now we can increment one more step. We have a step size, just in a different color. We have a step size of 1. So we're gonna in each step we're gonna increment x by 1. And so we're now going to be at 1. Now what's our new y going to be? Well, if we increment x by 1 and our slope is negative 2k, that means we're going to increment y by negative 2k times 1, or just negative 2k. So negative 2k. So k plus negative 2k is negative k. So our approximation using Euler's method gets us the point 1, negative k. And then what is going to be our slope starting at that point? So 1, negative k. Our slope is going to be 3 times our x, which is 1, minus 2 times our y, which is negative k now. And this is equal to 3 plus 2k. 3 plus 2k. And now we'll do another step of 1, because that's our step size. Now I'm going to get to 2. And this is the one that we care about, right? Because we're trying to approximate g of 2. So we have to say, well, what does our approximation give us for y when x is equal to 2? And if we're going to have something expressed in k, but they're saying that's going to be 4.5, and then we could use that to solve for k. So what's this going to be? So if we increment by 1 in x, we should increment our y by 1 times 3 plus 2k, which is just going to be, so we're going to increment by 3 plus 2k. 3 plus 2k, or negative k plus 3 plus 2k, is just going to be 3 plus k. 3 plus k. And they're telling us that our approximation gets that to be 4.5. So 3 plus k is equal to 4.5. So the k that we started with must have been, if we just subtract 3 from both sides, this is a decimal here, it must have been, k must be equal to 1.5. And you can verify that. If this initial condition right over here, if g of 0 is equal to 1.5, g of 0 is equal to 1.5, and if you put 1.5 over here, then over here you would get 4.5. And we're done.